the case of papillary cancer of the thyroid, our classic patient is going to be a female with a slow-growing thyroid nodule. Additionally, these patients may present in some cases with lymphadenopathy on physical exam. This is in part because papillary cancer of the thyroid moves via lymphatic spread, and it should be noted that patients are at an increased risk for papillary cancer of the thyroid if they have RET or BRAF mutations, or if they have a history of childhood radiation, especially to the neck. In order to diagnose papillary carcinoma of the thyroid, we are going to need a tissue sample, which is going to reveal orphan antinuclei. More on this in the coming slides. These orphan antinuclei classically will have empty appearing nuclei with a central clearing. Additional features that we will see histopathologically in our patients with papillary cancer of the thyroid include somoma bodies and nuclear grooves. Again, more on this in the coming slides. Much like our other types of thyroid cancers, the hallmark of management in papillary cancer of the thyroid is going to be either a partial or total thyroidectomy. Additionally, for high-risk patients, we can supplement surgery with the use of radioiodine ablation, as well as giving levothyroxine in order to suppress the patient's TSH. This decreases the amount of TSH stimulation of the thyroid, thus increasing our chances of ultimately getting rid of this tumor of the thyroid. This is because we do not want continued TSH stimulation of the thyroid when that is the very tissue that we are trying to get rid of. As we stated previously, papillary carcinoma of the thyroid has these classic histopathologic features. As we stated, we can see the presence of orphan antinuclei. These can be appreciated, for example, here, where we can see this central clearing. This is pretty classic for orphan antinuclei. Additionally, these patients may have somoma bodies histopathologically, and we will show examples of this in the coming slides. And last but not least, we can see nuclear grooves in our patients with papillary cancer, and we can see a couple examples of this. For example, here, where you can see this linear groove or nuclear groove, and this is highly classic for papillary carcinoma of the thyroid. Somoma bodies are also another characteristic histopathologic feature that we see in papillary carcinoma of the thyroid, and this can be appreciated in this classic histopathologic image here on the right-hand side of the presentation, where we essentially have these concentric loops. Somoma bodies can be found in several high-yield conditions that love to show up on board examinations, and these can be remembered by the mnemonic PSMM, as these letters appear quite literally in the word somoma bodies. These high-yield conditions include papillary carcinoma of the thyroid, serous papillary, cysta adenocarcinoma of the ovary, meningioma, as well as mesothelioma.